The government of Kenya is broke. Okay? And this is official. This is not rumors. This is not fake news. This is official. Spoken by none other than the CS Finance, Henry Rotich. Okay? Now, Henry Rotich appeared before the Parliamentary Finance Committee earlier today. And in answering questions, he admitted, he confessed that the government of Kenya is broke. Indeed, the situation is so serious that the government plans to soon put a bill before Parliament to amend the Division of Revenue Act 2017. Okay? This is concerning the allocation of revenue to counties. Yeah? This is going to be reviewed so as to reduce the amount of money going to the counties. And this is not because the Jubilee government has money and does not want to disperse the money to the counties. This is not because the Jubilee government wants to sabotage counties, yeah, although the people would argue against that. But in this case, that's not the reason. The reason is very simple. The government does not have the money. Why doesn't the government have money? Why is the government broke? Well, according to Rotich, the reason is because of the prolonged electioneering period, yeah, that took its toll on the economy and on the government being able to raise finances as it usually does. And then he also says the prolonged drought. Those are the two main reasons he has given why the government is broke. Now, regular listeners of this channel, you will know that we predicted this last year. Yeah, towards the end of last year, we predicted that there would be a major financial troubles within the government of Kenya. Now, if you took in that recording, you will know that this is the beginning of a very major crisis, okay, within the country, a major crisis of the financial kind. Of course, the situation is made much worse by the fact that the government continues to borrow as if there's no tomorrow, okay? Now, you don't need to be an economist to know that when you're in a financial hole, when you're in a financial crisis, the way out of it is certainly not to borrow more. You're already in debt, you're borrowing more. That is definitely not the solution. Now, to make things even sadder, and you know this is one of the dirtier things about politics the world over, is the fact that there's a very high possibility that what the Jubilee government will do to deal with this problem is that instead of handling the root cause of the problem, yeah, what they'll do is to look for ways, one of them, of course, is borrowing, to look for ways of patching up the leaks in the ship, yeah, to look for ways of putting short-term kirakas, yeah, so that they're able to limp until 2022. Okay? And then 2022, it will be somebody else's problem, another administration's problem, etc., etc. Now, this kind of short-term thinking is normally devastating to a country. And it takes a very wise leader to rise above the politics, to rise above the political consequences, and to make decisions that can stand the test of time, and to make decisions that are good for the country in the long term going forward. Sadly, that is something we do not have in Kenya. And therefore, the only thing I can say, unfortunately, is brace yourself, folks. Brace yourselves for some very, very rough terrain ahead. Until next time, this is Chris Kumekucha.